In part 1 of Learning UniRx, we learned that reactive programming is programming with data streams. In UniRx, data streams are known as observables. In this video, we'll be taking a closer look at what observables are, how they're implemented, and some of the Unity-specific observables that are provided by UniRx. An observable represents a sequence of events. Each event results in the observable emitting a value. Observers subscribe to observables and react to the values that they emit. Every flavor of reactive extensions must follow a contract that defines how observables should be implemented. The contract is as follows. An observable should communicate with its observers via the following notifications. OnNext tells the observer that an item has been emitted. OnCompleted tells the observer that the observable has completed successfully and will no longer be emitting values. And OnError tells the observer that the observable has been terminated due to a specified error and will no longer be emitting values. Furthermore, the contract states that an observer will communicate with an observable via the following instructions. Subscribe tells the observable that an observer is ready to receive notifications. And unsubscribe tells the observable that the observer no longer wants to receive notifications. This custom observable, created using the static create method, gives us a better idea of how these notifications are called under the hood. Create takes a delegate method that provides access to the observer. This is where you can call onNext, onCompleted, and onError. In the case of our example, the delegate loops through an array of numbers, emitting each value and then waiting for 1 second. Then it calls onCompleted to let the observer know that the observable is completed successfully and will no longer be emitting values. The observer that's subscribed to this custom observable simply writes the emitted values to the console. As you learn more about observables and their operators, you'll want to become more familiar with marble diagrams. Marble diagrams help you visualize what observables are actually emitting. This is a marble diagram of the custom observable from the previous example. The circles, or marbles, represent the values that this observable emits. The line that they sit on represents the flow of time. Remember, these values are emitted 1 second apart from each other. The line at the end of the marble diagram represents the completion of the observable. Now, the example didn't include an error, but if it did, it would be represented by an X, like so. Soon, I'll cover operators and how they filter, transform, and combine observables. These can all be visualized by marble diagrams as well. Take the select operator. The emitted values flow into this box that represents the transformation. Then they flow down into a new observable that is visualized by its own marble diagram. Marble diagrams are powerful tools that can help you fully grasp and understand how the more complicated operators are affecting your observables. So far, we've talked about what observables are and how we can create our own. But for the most part, you'll generally want to rely on the observables that are provided by UniRx. These built-in observables, which are also known as triggers, are specific to Unity, turning monobehavior events such as update and onCollision enter into streams of data that you can subscribe to. This simple example shows a monobehavior that logs the name of each game object that it collides with. First, it needs to import unirx.triggers. Then, it subscribes to onCollisionEnter as observable in its start method, where it calls debug.log, passing in the name of the collision's game object. This is the naming convention that's used for all monobehavior events, with the name of the event followed by as observable. From updates to collisions to mouse events, UniRx comes packed with support for all of the most commonly used monobehavior events. There are also a couple of Unity-specific gems, such as reactive properties, that I'll cover in another video. In the next video, we'll be talking about the different types of operators that are available in UniRx. Operators allow you to filter, transform, and combine your observables, giving you more fine-grained control over how you compose your asynchronous code. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like and a comment letting me know what you thought. And for more Unity tutorials just like this one, please subscribe with notifications on. And if you'd like to support the creation of content like this, please consider becoming a patron on the Infallible Code Patreon page.